around campus or within campus to see smokers on the sidewalks or within 25 feet of building. But this time next year, that could be changing if we plan on, well, Western plans on implementing this tobacco-free campus policy. Today I'm going to inform you about the tobacco-free policy that we are going to put in place in September 2014. And I'm credible to speak on this because I've done extensive research on this, as well as I work with the campus and I have to inform students as well. So today I'm going to inform you of what the new policy is, what other colleges have adapted this policy, and also strides that Western is taking to aid their students and staff in quitting smoking. Our current policy, according to Roland in the Western Michigan News article in 2013, we currently have a smoke-free policy, which means that there is no smoking allowed in or within 25 feet of campus buildings. And this will remain into effect until September 2014. So now that I've told you the old policy, I'm going to explain to you our new policy. The new policy, according to that same article by Roland in 2013, states that it will prohibit the sale and use of all tobacco-related merchandise on campus or at university-sponsored events. And once in effect, the only area students will be able to smoke would be in their personal vehicles. And according to Peralta in the Ann Arbor News article in 2013, this will apply to all university faculty, staff, students, and visitors. Now that I've told you the new policy, I'm going to show you some examples of other colleges that have adapted this. According to Chandler in the Western Herald article in 2013, over 1,150 U.S. colleges and universities have already placed this tobacco-free policy as of April 2013. And there are more than 20 campuses in Michigan that have already adapted this. For example, U of M, Hope College, Grand Rapids Community College, and Oakland University, just to name a few. Now that I've explained to you some colleges that have also adapted this, I'm going to show you what Western is taking to help students quit smoking. As the campus transition, Western will be offering tobacco cessation services to support its members who are interested. And according to the Western Herald article, Syracuse has also created the Pick the Nick program, which provides options for nicotine replacement, consultations with tobacco cessation specialists, and prescription products to stop the use of tobacco. As we come to a close, today I've discussed with you what the tobacco-free policy entails, other schools that have already implemented this policy, and finally, the steps our university is taking to provide support to its students and faculty. I hope you are informed on this tobacco-free policy, and you guys will help others be aware of this policy. And according to Dr. Dunn in the Western Herald article by Chandler 2013, states that one thing I want to emphasize is we are not saying that you cannot smoke, but we are saying that this environment is smoke-free.